Hello dear students, today we are going to start second part of the chapter 15, some natural phenomena. In our previous part we discussed about what are electric charges, how the object get charged with different methods, friction, conduction, induction, and also we discussed about the electroscope and we discussed the uses and the structure of electroscope in detail. So let us start today's session with a few more topics that are lightning and earthquake in detail. To know what are the reason behind lightning and earthquake and how to protect ourselves during this natural phenomena. Dear students, in this session we will discuss two main natural phenomena that are lightning and earthquake. Lightning is streak of bright light and sound caused by electrical discharge between clouds and earth or between different clouds. And earthquake is a sudden shaking of earth caused by the disturbance deep inside the earth crust. Lightning and earthquake cause a lot of damage to human life and property. So let us discuss each of them in detail. After studying about electric charges, we can understand how lightning occur on the stormy night in the sky. During the development of a thunderstorm, there is an upward movement of air current, while the water droplets move downward. Due to the friction between both of them, positive and negative charges separate from each other. The positive charge accumulate near the upper edge of the cloud and the negative charge accumulate near the lower. As you can see in the picture, it is shown. The positive charge also collect near the ground. As you know, air is a poor conductor of electricity. Yet when the magnitude of collected charge becomes very large, air no longer is able to hold it or stop it. Hence, the negative charge meet the positive charge, producing the bright light streak in and a loud sound, which we call lightning. And this process is also called electrical discharge. The process of transfer of charges from a charged object to the earth is called earthing or grounding or discharging. Generally, every building is provided with earthing to protect it from electrical shocks due to leakage of electric current. The device which is used to protect the building from lightning is known as lightning conductor. Clouds can also charge tall buildings, poles, wires and trees by induction. Sometimes if the charge is too heavy, they can catch fire. To protect the building from such damage, electric conductor is fixed on it. It consists of a metal rod with spikes, as you can see in the picture shown, at the top and a copper plate attached at the lower end. And the copper plate is buried under the earth so that when the lightning strike, its extra charges flow to the earth metal rod without causing any damage to the building. Let us discuss about the safety measures that we can take during the lightning. Lightning can hit anyone in wrong place at the wrong time. It can also hit the same place many times too. So we need to take precautions to protect ourselves from lightning. So what are that protection measures? Let us discuss. Do not stand under a tree. If the tree gets hit by lightning and catches fire, definitely it will harm you. Do not remain in an open place. Take shelter inside a building or a parked vehicle with all its door and windows closed. If you are out in the open with no safe place, squat down with your feet together and only let your feet touch the ground. Do not use electric appliances as you can see in the picture, when lightning strikes, because electric appliances are very easily attracts the electricity towards them. Stay away from the water. Do not touch a shower, because water is again a good conductor of electric current. Do not go on the terrace or roof of any tall building. These are the precautions we can take during lightning to keep ourselves safe and secure. Let us discuss about the another natural phenomena, that is earthquake. You must have heard about the massive destruction caused by the earthquake to life and property in various parts of the earth. You must have also heard that some areas are prone to earthquake. So let us study the structure of earth to know why a particular area is prone to the earthquake. Earth consists of three layers. Topmost, outermost layer is crust. It is solid shell of the earth. It is of non-uniform thickness and is thinner at the ocean floor. Second layer, middle layer, that is mantle. It lies just below the crust. It consists of semi-solid rocks, iron and other minerals. Then inner layer, that is core, innermost part of the earth, and is divided into two sections, outer core and inner core. The crust and the upper layer of the earth is not in one piece. It is divided into many fragments called tectonic plates. These plates move continuously. When the tectonic plates rub against each other or collide with each other, they cause a disturbance in earth crust. These movement of plates result in earthquake, volcanic eruption or tsunami. So let us discuss the earthquake in detail. And sudden movement or disturbance in the lithosphere is called earthquake. It can be caused due to many reasons: volcanic eruption, underground nuclear explosion, collision of meteor or earthquake, movement of tectonic plate, etc. Here we will discuss the earthquake occurrence due to the movement of tectonic plates. When these plates move, they rub against each other and move and get interlocked. This prevents them from moving. Force pushing the two plates from beneath creates tremendous pressure against the plate. As the pressure continues to build, it pushes the two plates apart. This sudden movement of the tectonic plates sends wave of high energy in all direction within and along the surface of earth. The waves are called seismic wave. Dear students, do you know where the earthquake originate? It originate at the point which is called seismic focus. It is the point from where the edges of plate give away. And another point on earth's surface directly above the focus or hypocenter is called epicenter. Let us see how to observe or measure the seismic wave. Seismic waves are measured with the help of seismograph, which consists of pendulum bob or a vibrating rod suspended with a string. A pen is attached to the bob upside down. A paper roll is placed on the rotating drum that is fixed to the base of the seismograph. The instrument is fixed to the ground. When the earth shakes, the base also shakes, and the tip of the pen records the movement of earth on the graph paper. The record of the seismograph on the graph paper is called seismogram. Dear students, do you know how the magnitude of earthquake is measured? The magnitude of an earthquake can be measured on a scale
called Richter scale. It was developed by Charles Francis Richter. The scale has marking from 0 to 9. Earthquakes are classified on the basis of reading of the scale. 0 to 2, it is unnoticed. 2 to 4, it can be felt but not damaging. 4 to 6 is moderate. And 6 to 8, it is severe. And 8 to 9, very severe. Let us discuss the destructions caused by earthquake. Earthquake can cause great damage to mankind and the property. Earthquake can change the whole landscape of a place by deforming the ground. High intensity earthquake can uproot electric poles, telephone wires, and trees. Strong vibration caused by earthquake can burst gas cylinder, short circuit the electric wire, etc. How we can protect ourselves during earthquake? Let us discuss the points. While constructing a building, consult a qualified architect or engineer to minimize the effect of earthquake on the structure. Do not construct the building on landfill or area which is weak to support a building. Use light construction material like timber or mud in highly seismic area. Fix bookcase and cabinet, cupboards and shelf securely to the wall so that they do not fall easily. Keep fire fighting equipments handy. Whenever required, you can get them easily. Repair any crack in the wall or ceiling. What personal safety measures can be taken? Let us discuss that also. Take shelter when you are caught in this situation. Take shelter under a heavy table or keep away from tall buildings and heavy objects that may fall on you. If you are in a bed, do not get up. Protect your head with a pillow. Avoid using a lift. Leave the building you are in and move to the open area. Stay inside a car or bus if you are traveling. Ensure that vehicle is not near an electric pole or a tall building. In this way, we can protect ourselves during the earthquake. Here we have completed explanation part of the chapter. Soon we will share question answers with you. Till then, take care and have a nice day ahead.